Hey everyone, sorry I've pretty much been MIA lately these past couple of weeks. I've just been really busy with stuff, but today I'm going to explain quickly the difference between transgender and transsexual. Now, someone who is transgendered identifies as something other than their biological gender. So, a biological male would identify as a female, and a biological female would identify as a male. Now, someone who is transsexual is someone who has undergone sex change surgery, meaning someone who was biologically a male is now female, and someone who was biologically female is now male. Now, the main difference between the two is that if I were to call myself transgendered, since I'm biologically male, I would identify as female. But if I was transsexual, I would have been a biological male who has undergone sex change surgery to become female, so now I would be a girl. Now, just to clarify, I don't identify as either. Now, along with transgender and transsexual, you can also get other terms such as genderqueer, which means you don't necessarily fit on the male and gender side of the spectrum, you fit somewhere in between there. Now, I did a project on the difference between gender and sex in my AP Psychology class, so I'd like to read some of what I wrote for it. So, under diagnosis, according to athealth.com, a diagnosis of gender identity disorder is given when a person identifies with the opposite sex to the point of believing they were born in the wrong body. This belief starts early at childhood and grows and develops as the child matures and gets older. So it happens at a very early age and only gets stronger as you grow older as a person. To think of how hard and traumatic things can be for someone who's transgendered, think of it this way. You're a girl, but you're born with a dick. Or you're a boy, and you have no dick. Think of it that way. Now, during puberty, they start to undergo a lot of very hard changes, such as a biological male who identifies as female will start to develop facial hair and get a deeper voice, and a biological female who identifies as male will start their period and develop breasts, which in their eyes feels like a betrayal of their bodies. It doesn't feel right to them. They feel that they are in the wrong body. Puberty can be suppressed, however, until the age of 16 with the gonadotropin releasing hormone analog, or a GnRH analog. After this, an endocrinologist will recommend starting testosterone therapy in a biological girl and estrogen and progesterone therapy in biological boys, only after being carefully analyzed by a psychotherapist to make sure that they are truly transgender. Before recommending a child to GnRH therapy, the therapist will try to resolve the issue between their gender and their sex. However, if the attempt fails and the teen still believes they were born in the wrong body, the therapist will recommend hormone therapy. A good therapist will give all the possible risks that come with hormone therapy, which include infertility and loss of bone density. But the teen's desire to still undergo the therapy shows that they can see no other option to live as their true self. After the therapist carefully analyzes them for many number of years, and they see that they are truly transgendered, they can start surgery around the age of 18. Surgical options include a hysterectomy, castration, breast implants or mastectomy, and finally genital reassignment. Very few doctors are qualified to perform genital reassignment surgery because of the very complicated process that comes with it. Now, if you know anyone who is transgendered, it's very important that you try to talk to them and help them through any struggles that they have and let them know that you're there for them and that you're willing to listen to them no matter what, because gender identity disorder is real, it's painful, and it's very confusing. The best thing you can do to help someone who is transgendered is to listen to them and show that you care. As long as everyone is willing to listen, we can push forward to more tolerance and acceptance. Thank you.